Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to answer a question from, and sorry in advance for butchering your name, Supriya Shrivastava, perhaps? Not good with names, and this is actually a name I had never seen before, so I hope I pronounced it somewhere what right. Hi, can you please tell me how to read Swagger file JSON using Java and need to extract request and response pairs? I have tried to read it from Swagger parser, but it's not working. Well, I have set up this parser here. I'm not really sure what's the thing that it isn't working, so I thought I go through what I've built today, what I've learned, and what things I have encountered, and maybe that will be a help for you to build what you like to build. I guess you are trying to do a very specific implementation in some way, and if you can be more specific, I can try to help you to answer your specific question. But I start off with this Notes API that I have in my Swagger video, the other one that got this question. And this Notes API has a description, a very simplistic API. Notes, it has some more metadata. Later down here we have some paths, and we have one of the paths, it's called notes. It has a getter and a specific operation, and this operation I used inside of my code in order to trigger a specific function. And then it has some responses, and these have descriptions, a schema of a type array, and some items. And what I wanted to do was actually print out some of this information. So I wanted to print out a description, I wanted to print out this full tree, and also find the specific reference to the definition down here so I can know the structure of the response data. And what I have implemented here, if you look at the first example, I actually got out this description, I got the path and the type of the operation, the ID of the operation, all the parameters. In this case, it doesn't have any parameters, but if you look at the post here, you have a note as a parameter. I haven't handled this comma, but I didn't really worry about that. It's an implementation detail. And in the responses here, I have typed out the response key and the description, and also the different properties in the model of this note. So if we look in the bottom here of my file, I have a note and it has properties ID and text of type string. So that's what I wanted to do with this implementation, and it actually prints out all of them that I have in my document. So let's look at the code. If we start from the top here, I read the JSON file, and this JSON file is located in my project. So this current project, just for a short introduction, I can say that in my POM file here, my Maven project, I use the Swagger parser 1.0.32. So you know what version I'm using, so you get the same result. And yeah, so you can try this yourself. Then I just, when I get this Swagger object, when I have read this JSON file, I get the info and the description. And this, all these functions follow the specific structure of the JSON document. So it's quite easy to follow the different paths in the JSON documents, because you usually get a function with the same name as the property in the JSON. And then I wanted to fetch all the paths, and I get an entry set of them, print out the key. So this is this key up here, slash notes. And then I print my operation. So I send my values operation map down to my print operation function. And the operations map actually has get as a HTTP method and all the other parameters on everything else in the operation as the other part of that map. And I also send my swagger through all the way down, because in the last function I want to use the swagger object, the document object, to get the definition that we have in the bottom. So I will pass that through to my functions. This print operations here, it takes this map that I get in with the HTTP method and operation. It will loop through those and print out the key, as you see here, get, and then the operation ID. It will print out all the parameters and just print the name of them with a comma after. So those are the parameters you see down here in the post call or the post request. And then I will print the responses. So I will send the responses map through to my print response value, the print response function. Here I first type out responses, then I will loop through the entry set of my responses. I will print the key of the responses here as well, and this is 200 in this case. And then the description, get all notes. And now the interesting part comes when you want to actually fetch the model with the reference down to your model. So if we look in the JSON file here, we have at our get endpoint, we actually have a schema which is a type of an array with items, and this items array has a reference to another model in definitions, and this makes it a little bit convoluted. So first off, I wanted to fetch the schema, check that it was of a type of array property, and then I get my array property, get the items, and check that this item that I get out is an ref property. So that's a reference property. And in the reference property, if I get a reference property, I will send that to my print reference function, which is the next part. And this is more straightforward. I will look at the reference format in this document and check that it's an internal reference, because you can actually have a reference to a URL or a reference to an external document, and we don't want to look at those types of reference, only references internal to this document. And then I get the definitions and check if the simple ref key is inside of my definition. So if I have the definitions for this simple ref key, and if I do, I will fetch that model from my definitions. So I will get a model, and the model has properties. So I get the properties and the entry set of those. I loop through those and get each of those entries and type out the key, which is ID in this case, and then I type out the type of this property. So then I will get string. I can also in this list print out description and anything else that I have in there. Another thing that is interesting is when you use operations up here, if you don't want to loop through all the operations, you don't want to fetch the operation map, you actually on this entry get value, so I get a specific path, you actually has get delete to get the delete operation, get to get the get operation, get head to get the head operation, and so on. So all the different operations can be fetched by name, because you have a fixed set of specific operations that can be done on a specific endpoint. So that's a very good shortcut if you want to fetch a specific type of operations and use those or work with those in your document. So this was what I wanted to cover in this video. I hope that you learned something from this. I hope that I made the functionality of this Swagger parser a little bit more clear. I hope that you can use this to write your implementation. And if you have any questions at all about this implementation or how to build your API, please contact me again. I will try to answer that as well. This little example I will put up on GitHub and call Swagger Reader or something on my class buffers. And always I will link it in the description below so you can go directly there. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. If you like this video, do that. And I really hope to see you in the next one.